We have Nizaam Carr on the line, believe it or not. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
How are you doing?
I'm very well. Obviously, feeling.
I'm broke to you, my
brook. I can't really describe it, but I mean, with yesterday's news and winning the Curry Cup on Saturday, it's really one for the record books here.
If I can ask you, Nizaam, when are you coming into studio to come and talk about it?
look, my time is a bit limited now because I'm flying out to Johannesburg.
No problem.
And then on Saturday, we're flying out to Ireland to play, you know, Ireland. So I know the time is not so great, but it would be great to come and you guys,
yeah. We'd love to have you on, inshallah, maybe when you get back. Talk us through the fact that now you've been selected. You've so seen your name in the paper as part. I would imagine it wasn't in the paper the first time you saw it. It would have been in a letter of some sort. But just talk us through it. Talk us through how hard you've been working for so many years. This must be a dream come true.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's basically every young boy, any guy's rugby dream to, you know, to be part of that rugby, you know, Springbok squad. So, I mean, I've been doing it, you know, training hard, being dedicated, motivated throughout my life. To get opportunity now, it's really great. I mean, from where I started, you know, I have to be thankful and grateful to, you know, my people from Mitchell's Plain, all my clubs, Collegians, Primroses, Caledonian Roses. So, you know, all these people are obviously part of my success because they, in the end of the day, they take me to, you know, the trial matches for Western Province. You know, I'm grateful for my dad as well, for my mom for always being there, motivating me. So, it's really been really a roller coaster, but, and also with injuries that, you know, I had major setbacks. You know, I was out in 2012. With a major knee injury, and then last year I didn't make the cut for the Curry Cup final, and then there was massive doubt this year that whether I would play in the final now that just passed. So those 3 years was obviously tough, but standing here today, in the end of the day, it's really, you know, all worth it, and I wouldn't trade it for anything or anyone there.
Indeed, and we are going to obviously try and keep you on for a bit longer, just to ask you one or two, if you don't mind. We'd just like to know from you, you've got so much support from especially young rugby players that are definitely from the, not only the Muslim community, but from the Cape Town community as a whole, looking to you as a role model and looking to you as someone that you can achieve it, even because, I mean, considering your size, you are quite small compared to a lot of the other guys out there, but you are still right there in the face, as ferocious as ever, and definitely more than worth your spot in the Springbok team. Can you tell us about how you view your role as a role model for young South Africa, for young Cape Townian rugby players?
Look, I think I've, you know, come a long road, obviously. Like I said, I grew up in Mitchell's Plain, so my support base is quite big. And then in 2005, I moved to Rondebosch, and I also attended Bishop's High School. So, I do a lot of community work and giving back to the youth, so I think that's the way I win a lot of people's hearts over. I mean, it's that's how my opportunity was created, through tournaments and trials. So, and also that's why I also started an academy. And if I could, you know, give that opportunity back to those guys, it will, you know, really fulfill my heart and bring happiness to my heart. So it's all about, you know, it's not just about rugby. It's more to life than just rugby. It's about people, you know, your family, representing your community. So it's really special, you know, that people acknowledge me and support me, you know. So it's really it's been a memorable season for me, and one for the record books.
Assalamu alaikum, Nizaam. This is Yusuf here. I say congratulations to you on your achievements. MashaAllah, Mabruk. We're all very proud of you. Tell me, did you get any slack on your wearing a beard?
Yes, I have. And a lot of the journalists always ask, what's it with a new beard and where's the scrum cap, what happened? But, you know, it's the sunnah, and it's, you know, it's a great example for other younger kids to follow, yeah.
Yes,
and it just happens to be that many other rugby players are also wearing big beards at the moment.
Yes, yes,
like your colleague, one would imagine, Dwayne Vermeulen, and you must have quite a good relationship with some of those guys as well, the bearded crew, as they say.
Yeah.
Indeed. So Nizaam, we say shukran to you for joining us, and hopefully when you do get back from your rugby playing, and we obviously we have our eyes glued to the television sets, but when you do come back, we'd like to speak to you a bit further, inshallah.
Yes, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum to you.
Wa alaikum salam.